So with that, let's get our, we've got a craft talk today from our TV, newest Blue Badger. So Shannon, you want to come up here and tell us all about yourself?
Oh, super official. Okay, first of all, I've never had to do a presentation, like a slideshow presentation, so totally winging this. I just stressed me out tremendously. And I'm not afraid to stand in front of people at all. It's just kind of talking about yourself a little awkward. So here we go. Shannon D. Macy. Can anybody guess what my middle name is? I just want to see if anybody's parents would do this to them.
Good light, Douglas.
Dorothea. And that's horrible. Yeah, they were going to call me Lacey, and my dad wanted to name me Gertrude, and then they ended up with Shannon, and then punished with my great-grandmother. So I was born on September 16th, 1973. I love my birthday, and you'll see that a little bit later on. So my parents are Pat and Rick Franklin. Yep, do the math. I'm 44 years old, born and raised in Scotia, and then moved to Fortuna. And I moved to McKinneyville chasing my sweet little husband down in 1998. I have a wife to Big Daddy for 18 years. His name's Travis. And he gets ticked off. He works in the car industry, and people used to go in and ask, is Big Daddy here? He's like, will you tell him my name? I've been in banking for 25 years, and I'm currently at Rova Capital Bank, Vice President and Relationship Manager is my title. I do commercial lending. I've done tons of things in banking. I managed my first branch at 24 years old, so I have been new accounts, teller. I've just kind of done it all. I've been licensed to do sell stocks and bonds, and mortgage lending, consumer lending, and now commercial lending. So, and I've managed for 17 years of it. So, help us sister out. Okay, this is how cute I was as a kid. Look at all that hair, isn't that adorable? I was super cute. You'll notice I'm not a different any of like my middle age. But there's two kids in here with their shirt off, and that was my cousin Damien and me. So I was a total tomboy growing up. I love sports and like to get dirty. There I am. This is my cousin Damien. Our moms are twins. And so Damien and I were 6 months apart. They used to dress us alike. At this birthday party, I don't have a picture of it, but at this birthday party, they sang to us, and Damien and I went to sit down, and somehow we got scooted over too far, and we fell on the floor when we went to sit down, and our moms were in the back. My mother did pee her pants laughing. So that's what I was working with. And I used to get in trouble because I always make it into all the pictures. Like I would come sliding into that one. So they had to talk to my parents about Shannon always getting in pictures. And then I played sports all through. I played softball since I was 5 years old. Up through college, I played basketball and softball in college. And my best friend, my freshman year, I never played tennis, said, Shannon, let's play tennis. And I said, okay, whatever. And then she only made it 1 year, and I ended up playing all four and was ranked number one on our team and second in the county. And I played basketball at College of the Redwoods and softball actually at Shasta as well in college. So nice form, don't you think? That was good form. let me put the whole thing in there. So this is my dad, Rick. He was killed in an accident in 1992. Some of you might remember it. At PL, three men were killed in a Barker. I was 18 years old when I lost my dad. But boy, let me tell you, this guy left me with a life full of memories. He's one of a kind. Every year on the day of his death and his birthday, we take a shot of Fireball. Me, my mom, my brother all get together and take a little shot of Fireball for the record. He's an amazing man and has left a lot of impact and taught me a lot of things about life and the time I had with him, and I'm thankful for that. Biggest regret is to take him to meet my boys or my husband, but so lucky.
pretty mother. I love my mom. She is truly amazing, probably my best friend. She's been a rock through everything that she's had to deal with in life. She's had a lot of scares with my brother and I. My brother has recently had some heart issues, and I had thyroid cancer, and I've had a lot of health issues, 5 surgeries in 13 months, and so my poor mom has really had to deal with a lot of stuff in her life, and she's such an amazing woman, and I hope I can be half as amazing as she is. And she comes up every Sunday and helps me cook and clean and do a bunch of stuff with the boys. She lives in Fortuna and I live in McKinleyville, and I pay her though, so don't think that she's like healthy reviews or anything like that. I get to help my mom now, so I do. But it's fun for me too, as I get to help my mom. So, and this is my big brother, Nate. He's huge. He's 6'6". He's pretty entertaining himself. Haven't always had the best relationship, but we like each other now. Growing up, we did not. I'm not gonna lie about that. And here's Big Daddy, super handsome, huh? I met him playing softball, and he had another girlfriend. He was trying to get me to go home with him. I was like, yeah. So I wasn't impressed. Clearly, I saw that baby. I'm like, he's good looking. I didn't know, but still, but I made it to him on a date. Not that easy. And then here are my babies, Trevin and Tice. They have this weird underwear thing. They would always do that. One day, Trevor took all of my underwear out. I couldn't find the picture. And then he had like, I don't know, 20 pairs of my underwear on his head. And then he couldn't get them off. He was really mad. Thank you for sharing all this. There's some more pictures of them. More. They're so sweet. I'm such a bad mom. Like, I ignored him so much. So this is one of my parenting techniques. So for those of you who aren't yet parents, this is a great thing. When they fight, I put them on what we call the love couch, and I need to sit there usually and hold hands. They still do it to them. They're 14 and 15 now. But the roles have totally reversed. Tice used to love it, and Trent was like, pissed at the world every time I did this. And then now Trent was like, oh, Tice, you want a hug? But I made them sit there and stare at each other and tell them great things about each other. So this is my son, Trevin. And when he was 4 years old, he was diagnosed with autism by Jan Paulus. So I joined FAM to help advocate and educate people on what autism is. And this little guy has taught me more about life than I think anybody. I don't know, it's just like, God gives you what you can handle. And I was like, holy crap, what did I get myself into? Because at 4 years old, he was nonverbal, he did not talk. And he is now in a freshman at McKinleyville High School in the mainstream classroom. He has had a one-on-one A most of his time in school, but he does not need one. They have somebody who kind of is in the classroom and helps him if he needs it, but he doesn't need the one-on-one support. He's amazing, incredibly intelligent, gifted on the computer. So he has the patience of a saint. But those of you that don't know about him, without him, Travis is like, Shannon, when I go everywhere, everybody knows we have an autistic son. I said, well, one, I know how ignorant I was. I remember being at the mall and seeing this mom with a kid on a leash. And I'm like, what the hell? That's like so rude. Well, I used to take the boys to get their pictures taken, and Trevin would take off running from me. And so I'd like, we'd have to ditch ties and take off after Trevin. And I'm like, I now know why people put their kids on a leash. It's not necessarily a discipline problem. There could be bigger issues. So I feel like I'm less judgmental as to what other people might be experiencing. And also, when I go to Safeway, it took me a year and a half with help to be able to go to the Safeway, to go to the store and do grocery shopping. I didn't want to leave my kids at home. If I wanted to go to the grocery grocery store. I wanted to be able to go to the grocery store. But Trevor was obsessed with numbers, so he would grab everything off the shelf, and I'm sweating. And so I told everybody that. I said, look, my kid has autism. I don't want your sympathy. I just want your understanding. And they did. They were amazing, and they helped me teach him how to be able to go to the grocery store. So that's my little stint. But FAN is an amazing organization. I'm no longer on the board, but if you ever see anything, I know I saw a sign downstairs, and they do wonderful things. We provided iPads to teachers in the school systems to help the kids that maybe need additional support. There's a lot of speak talk programs on iPads that help kids. Give them ability to be able to talk because it's a spectrum for a reason. They vary. Their abilities vary. So we do sensory screenings for movies and just a lot of amazing things. So if you ever have an opportunity to go to one of their events, go and support them.
Is there a walk coming up?
Yes. Yeah. This is Autism Awareness Month, the month of April. So there's a lot of local places that are they're donating part of the profits, or we had tiny for profits at the brewery last night at the Kennedyville, and Scarborough Edge is doing stuff, but there's tons of businesses that are donating part of their profits, and lots of events this month going on. And these are my handsome little nubs right now. Trevor does not smile. He's like, why do you want me to smile? That's not what I look like, but I never smile, so that's where he is. And then there's my little and then the other great thing in my life is being an aunt. I'm crazy aunt chicken Shannon to most of them. I have a nickname kind of from all different nieces and nephews. These guys call me Aunt Nightmare, and these guys are their favorite, even more favorite than their parents. So that's kind of cool. So this tells you what my nephews, the Nightmare nephews, think of me. They bought this for their father, my brother. Don't mess with me. My sister's crazy, and she will punch you in the face very hard. They bought this for my brother. And I got to marry my niece, Shelby. So I'm ordained. If anybody's, getting married, wants to renew some vows, I'm your girl. This is kind of a little fun story. My niece, Kayla, played basketball at Pacific University, and we made this cardboard cutout. When we went to her last game, well, Trevin became obsessed with this little cutout. So he'd make his bed, and he would put her head in it. And then he talked to her. He's microwaved his food. He has to watch microwave for his autism. And then he sat down with her and ate his food. It's totally hilarious to me. So share that. So I also love to scrapbook and craft. I have got to craft with Terry at Scrapper's Edge. We go and we do these things. But Rena also goes with us. We also take some journeys every now and then. I know you guys think what's news best, scrapbooking, but we do go on little retreats. And I fell asleep, and so they put all the Jell-O shots that everybody did in a garbage can, and then they took my picture with that, like I passed out, and put it on Facebook. Great friends. This, my birthday. It's the day I was born. I love it. I celebrated, start sending emails about a month ahead of time, letting everybody know if anybody wants to know what I want. I'm not shy about it. My coworkers committed a felon, though. They opened my mail because I bought this for the underwriters. Because I was going to go with them, and they loved Channing Tatum. And my staff thought somebody sent it to me for my birthday, so they put it up in my office, and it wasn't really mine, but I was giving it to somebody. And then I love to party. So this is my attempt at the worm. My staff refers to it as a banana slug. I'm all karaoke with no, I'm like no other. I'm the Auntie Queen, that's my jam, so if it comes on, it's a good day. And I'm not a good dancer and I'm not a good singer, but it's not going to stop me. And then this is kind of a fun fact about my mom. My mom loves the sun. So here's my mom all happy, drinking her cocktail, two Miami cocktails. She went in, kicked all the kids out of the pool. There was a whole bunch of kids in there, drunk, fully clothed, and there she is, passed out. You gotta love that. She'd kill me for showing that, but it's kind of entertaining. There's my mom, Trooper. These are some important people in my life. This is my cousin, Dina. Her mom and my mom are twins, but we're more like sisters. That's her little girl, Lexington, with she's just an awesome person. And then this is my friend Mandy McAllister. I used to work with her. We started baking a long time ago. And we had lost Amanda Jane about a year and a half ago. And she was just, to know Mandy is to love her. She's one of the best people you will ever meet. But she's important to me and has been a huge impact on my life. So I thought it was important to share Amanda Jane. And this is my best friend, Lindsay Johnson. I get to work with her every single day. And I know a lot of people don't get to get that with their best friend. So she's a pretty phenomenal person. So, and last is my boss and my friend, Jennifer Budway. She is our chief lending officer at Redwood Capital Bank. She's truly amazing. If you've never met Jennifer Budwig, you need to, because she's truly one of a kind. That's it.
Blue badge, not the help you've done it alone. So. And you can exchange now your red for blue badge.
Yeah. Yeah.